Hi, I'm Jeff Bradshaw, Redneck Restorations. This old truck brought to you by ElderlyIron.com, the internet's only auction site dedicated to old cars, trucks, tractors, and related parts. My 68 GMC won't start. Well, I've disconnected my fuel line from the filter. This is sporting a 671 Detroit NA. That stands for non-alcohol. And if you don't believe me, just try running alcohol through it and see what happens. So there's my line sticking over that nice can there. Gonna see if anything happens. My tripod's not tall enough to catch all the action. So you're just gonna have to live with what I got. Ready?
Contact!
Did you see anything? Nothing. That means I ain't getting no fuel.
Now my fuel gauge showed I had fuel and it's got about 6 inches in the tank. Contact. Wait a minute. I have a grip.
Well, with the camera precariously perched on the fender, I got a drip there toward the end of that last crank. That much. Well, I guess I'll go get a couple more 5 gallon cans of diesel.
But the station doesn't open till 7. Can't get any more diesel tonight. Mosquitoes are on the rise. Sun's going down. Wait till tomorrow. Okay, it's the next day, I got some help, and what's going to happen here, you should never start a diesel engine using starting fluid, like we're going to do here now, but in this case, but since we have just enough battery to crank it for a little while, and they say you can't get a Detroit back to running unless you have the fuel pump system and you purge all the air out of it. But what we're going to do is crank it a little bit, make sure we get fuel coming back to the filter. As soon as I can get this can to stay still. Okay. I'm just going to give it about a 2 second shot.
Yeah.
So crank it when it fires. Just let it die.
Yeah.
Until I see that we're getting fuel out of this.
All right.
You might even want to watch and see that it's coming.
Watch and see while I'm cranking. All right.
I think you can do it. I did it yesterday.
You think I got a giraffe neck? where's my line? Oh, it's going to come into the can?
Yeah. Whoa. Can you reach it?
Yeah, barely.
Let's do it.
Ready?
Yep.
Anything? Not that time. we'll see. But that won't. You get low. Can you set that can so it's right up against that filter?
No. Okay. I can, but it won't stay there.
Okay.
Thank you.
I can just see it. Yeah.
Gushing.
Yeah, she flew full line.
All right.
That's step one. That was awful quick.
Quick, that's the way we like it.
Well, that's why that wrench is up there.
Just happens to fit that line.
Yeah,
huh?
I bet.
Okay, now here's what we're going to do. I'm going to get this baby up and running on starting fluid. Give it about a 2-second shot. And just as it fires, you just keep doing like that with it. That'll keep the engine running long enough. And he's going to keep his foot right on the floor. That's going to put us in full fuel. And when it starts getting the fuel in there and popping off, then he'll know to keep the RPMs down below 1400. So keep the RPM down below 1400.
Gotcha.
That's only after it starts getting fuel.
Right.
Do it! Crank it!
Kick me loose. these kind of neighborhoods. This ain't a fancy truck. Here's our fishing bobber. Tells where our level is. I can't even see it on the screen. I'm just kind of pointing the camera. There it is. See? Told you could see it. It's our tank level. If you wonder why we open up the hydrant, blow the water out of them like that, because you probably didn't see it on camera, but all the orange, rust, and nasty crud, debris that's in the line, pluck that out if you don't want to put it in your tank.
That ought to do!
Thank you.
Well, I still gotta get back and move that water truck. Go to the sign-in sheet and then we'll get to it. Well, I better stick my battery cover on before I see him hanging off the side of the truck in the mirror by the cable. Like it almost is now.
Here anyway. Middle command, 8942.